brother. You're going to say your prayers and eat your vitamins. Come on, everybody. This is Jason, zombie collector extraordinaire. And I want to show you a hodgepodge, a cornucopia smattering of cards. So I was going through, I'm going to do a card show this Saturday with JT. He offered up a table. I don't know if it's just because he got it over his head and he didn't need an extra table, or after he looked at his spread, he was like, why do I need two tables? I really don't have enough for one. I don't know. Maybe he's just being generous and throwing me a bone. I don't know. But he said, hey, you can have one of the tables for the price that he paid for it or whatever. And I was like, all right. So I've been going through cards. Mine's like my table will be like a glorified yard sale. It has a little bit more direction than just a yard sale, but essentially it's a glorified yard sale of cards. But as I was going through a couple boxes, I found some stuff that I thought was kind of fun. And I didn't know I had these cards, so I wanted to put them away from my dollar box. The first ups were a couple Hulk Hogan cards. Yeah, brother. Got these 27-inch pythons just ready for Hulkamania to run wild on you. So I found some of those. And then I found this Nolan Ryan. This is all from Goodwin, by the way. Goodwin from Upper Deck. Then we got Abraham Lincoln. How can I get rid of Abraham Lincoln? I mean, come on, dude. Gettysburg Address. You know, he freed the slaves. Let's not give that away to somebody else. Then I found this World of Sports card. It's a Yuka Sato. Jeff Airtime Cards, this is for you. The only time I collect anything that's not baseball would be if the person's Japanese. I'll hold on to their card and put it away, put it in a top loader. I'll probably never look at it again. But at least I can say I have a famous ice skater, I guess. Then, talking about famous ice skaters, we got the body, Jesse Ventura. If you've seen The Predator, hey, you're bleeding. I got no time to bleed. Ain't no time to bleed. I'm sure I slaughtered that quote, but yeah. Who's got time to bleed? But Jesse the body, man, he has some luscious blonde locks back in the 70s and early 80s. He started going bald like Hulk Hogan, and then he just shaved it all off as he got older. Fast fact, maybe people don't remember, he, I believe, was the governor of Minnesota for a couple a decade or so, maybe longer. And so that was very interesting. Next up, we have JFK, which is very cool. We're having some history lessons today, guys. First Catholic president, youngest president ever elected to the presidency. And the very first Catholic, I think only Catholic, still to my knowledge. So there you go. Then we have Ryan Sandberg. Looks like he's in a golf outfit more than he is a baseball player. That's just a goofy looking smile. I don't know what's going on with that picture. You think it's kind of like that poor Austin Hayes card from last year. It's like of all the pictures you could use or portraits, that's the one you go for. The one he's like this. It's like, this weird. And then last and certainly not least, RIP baby, Stan the Man Lee right there with his incredible Hulk gloves. So there you go. So that was that. So that was the thing that I just found. I just thought they were fun. I'll just show them off. An eBay purchase I picked up. This was out of 75. I don't even know if I remember that being numbered for a dollar. Plus I got like $2 or $3 shipping. So I bought this for $4 total. But it's actually a dollar. It is a Barry Larkin relic card. I just love this card. It looks great from my Prime Cuts playoff. You have that. But there you go. I like these cards. I like the ones where they have like they took some time creating the design. I just enjoy that better than what I feel like they just flop it on there. Oh, floppy seconds. And then these are cards I picked up at Four Sharp Corners. I was there. I went through the dollar boxes, and these are – so I got all these cards for like a dollar, I think. Yeah, these all were a dollar. No, I'm sorry. These weren't – I went through this quarter box. These were all a quarter. So I got like $3 right here. So tell me if you thought I did okay. So first up I have a Kazuhisa Ishii card. Never seen this card before. Picked that up. Got a Hideo Nomo. from the what are these? Are these Donruss Classics? Yeah, Donruss Classics. Then I have a Matsuzaka from Heritage, all a quarter, and then a Hideki Matsui, right there. And I don't think I've ever seen this card before. Kazuhiro Sasaki, the pitcher for the Mariners. So I got that. These, like I said, all quarter. And then I have this Ishii card. And I have this Otsuka Akinori. Now I'm looking at it. I think I already have this card. But again, for a quarter, I'll be your Huckleberry. Then we got a Hideki Matsui. I know I don't have this one. So got that. And this is a cool one. Right? Oh, whoops. Whoa, that scared me. Hold on. I don't know if I did that. Okay, so we got this Ichiro, which I don't think I have this Ichiro. If I do, I don't think it was in this good a condition. They had one with some soft corners, so I picked that up. I'm pretty sure I didn't mean to put this in the style. Maybe he stuck that in. He's like, he snuck this card into my stack. I don't remember buying this. Then I got this Don Mattingly, Donnie Baseball. I think I have this, but I don't know if I think I have an uncut version. Or the one I have, again, it could have been, like, real cut too close and didn't give it a little bit of a border. So, that's cool. Then I got this Ichiro right here from Allen and Ginter. And this is one of the best finds of the day for me. It was only a quarter. And I think it's the second year of King Griffey Jr. Wonder Bread. Shout out Blue Jacket 66. I know you're super jelly this card. You're probably thinking, $200-$300, Jason, you buy this? No, I got it for a quarter, Dave. I mean, you know, after I get it graded as a Gem Mint 10, Pristine Hyper Extension Nitroglycerin Drop, it'll probably be like $6,000. But right now, 25 American cents. And then last, to me, this card here is worth $3 by itself. I kid you not, I don't even know why it was in a quarter box. There's literally nothing wrong with it. It's off-center. But it's a card from, I believe, 1972. You have two Hall of Famers on this card, and it's this right here. Harmon Killebrew and Frank Robinson. But look at this card, guys. Look at those corners. I mean, like I said, we know it's off-center right here to here. So from left to right, or right to left, on I think, on when you're looking at it, possibly. Left or right. And then top to bottom, obviously, is also off-center. The back is clean. Again, obviously, it's showing it's off center. But, I mean, for 25 cents, I mean, I would buy this, like I said, for $3 all day long. So there's that. So that was all for $3, that whole stack of cards. One or two of those cards are King Griffey Jr. and the 1971 All-Star RBI Leader card. I mean, let's just say they're $1.50 apiece. I feel like that's definitely worth it. And then for my birthday, Luca and his mother – bought me a box of Update, Topps Update. And I've only opened, I think, one of these this year, maybe two. And I think I've watched JT open maybe two or three in my house because he's bought some. And I personally hadn't had very much luck. The two or three that I had opened, or one or two, I didn't really get a whole lot, maybe a few rookie cards, nobody huge. So I wasn't really, like, super, like, overtly excited. I mean, I was excited about the present, but I wasn't expecting much. That's what I should say. But you know, every time my ex-wife buys me a couple boxes of cards for my birthday or for Christmas, and Luca picks them out for me, I'm always excited because, you know, they know that's stuff I like, and they are actively trying to find something they know I appreciate. So thank you to Luca's mom and to Luca. Domo arigato gozaimashita. So let me show you the rookie cards. Tell me if I have a rookie card I put a couple rookies that I know who they are, and they're not me prospecting, that there might be worth holding on to and top loading. If I show a guy that you think probably I should protect a little bit better than just putting it in a box with a bunch of raw cards like this, let me know. I'm just going to quickly show them. So we have Kelly Marcellius or something like that. I don't even know how to pronounce that guy's last name. Avila. Lovelady, Mr. Dick Lovelady. Dowdy. Thomas. France. Oh, Chante. Parlez-vous français? Comme ci, comme ça. Then we got Hernandez, Martin, or Martin, I guess, depends on where you're from. Canning. Then we have Pannoni. I don't know. Or Pannone. Or none of your business. Ho! Ho! Gutierrez. Another Canning? That's two different Cannings. Griffin, are they two different? I mean, was one a short print or something? Griffin Canning. Oh, one's a rookie debut. Okay. I was like, uh-oh. Oh, I missed a short print or something. Then we got Will Smith, the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. We got Irvin Shedlong. That name sounds familiar. Will Smith and Shedlong both sound familiar, but I don't know if it's just because they've been around the Cincinnati Reds or something, or because they're worth holding on to for a possible future value as far as, you know, good ball players. Crone, Clark, and then Renigfro. I don't know. I'm sure I slaughtered that. Then we got a rookie combos of Markel and McKay. Then we got this guy's name. It's almost as good as Dick Lovelady, Skybolt. I mean, obviously, these people's parents are doing this stuff on purpose. Did Lovelady's parents really call him Richard by accident? I don't think so. Did the guy's parents, who has last names Bolt, not purposely name him Sky? I mean, it's not going to happen. Chavis, I feel like I've heard that name a couple times. Hazley. And then lastly, Bergen. So those are the rookie cards. Then I'll show off the, big name stars and or inserts. Trouty, Yelich. This is Shohei Ohtani, which is nice. There's that subset that's in there. Paul Goldschmidt. Nice, right? That's a good one. Then we got Mookie Betts. All bets are off if he stays with the Red Sox. The other Shohei Ohtani as he's smiling and profiling. Then we got Justin Verlander. And then we have another Yelich here. Then we have Adam Jones. Mr. I see a boogeyman wherever I go. Out to get you. Then we got a Derek Jeter, which is a nice looking car, future Hall of Famer. Then we have, let's see here. We got this guy, Chad Bettis. Then we got Scott Alexander with the 150 logo, the gold 150. Then we have a Hanser Alberto gold, numbered out of 2019. This is 571. And then last and surely not least is Willie Mays, the Say Hey Kid. So those were the inserts and or, you know, possible Hall of Famers and superstars. And then lastly, these are the hits, so to speak. I don't even know. This is number 150. I don't even know what this is. This is number 56. I can't make out what's different about this card from another card. I honestly don't know. And then I never heard of this player, Luis Cessa. So if you all know why this card is marked, is numbered out of 150, I mean, it's a Yankee, so that's good. It's a pitcher, so that's not good. But, yeah, it doesn't say anything on there that says, hey, look at me, I'm special. So I got that number card. I got the gold card. Here's some of the rookie cards I hit. I got a rookie debut of Eloy Jimenez. Whatever you all think there. So I got that. Then I have a Pete Alonso rookie debut. I don't think these are considered their true rookie cards, and I understand that. Maybe they do. I don't know. But I put these in top loaders because I knew these names. A lot of people talking pretty big about them. Kevin Biggio. So there's that one. And then I have a Vladimir Guerrero Jr. This is my very first Guerrero Jr. I pulled out of a pack. So that's good. And then I knew this guy from JT. It's Luis Arraez or Arraez or Arraez. Rookie card. So you have that. And then I pulled the relic card or whatever, patch card, whatever they call that in here. Luca was so excited about pulling this card because he knew as soon as he saw the name, he knew I would like it. And usually these cards I looked at as flip or whatever and put in care packages because most times the players I could care less about. But this one, Johnny Bench. Super pumped about that. So Luca was hopping around like, oh, Dad, you're going to love this card. It's one of the players you like. And I was like, ooh, I can't wait. And it's Mr. Bench. And then last and surely not least, I pulled an autograph out of here. And it was actually I who pulled it out. Usually Luca gets all the good luck with opening cards and they have some kind of cool thing to pull. It's an on-card autograph of a rookie. However, he's a pirate. So we already know it's probably going to be worth like a few schmeckles if we're lucky. Sorry, Bob, but the Pirates suck and there's nobody on their team that I'm aware of that's any good. This guy may be down the road. He's still a rookie. But it's a really cool on-card autograph. And it's on-card. So here it is. Of Brian Reynolds. Everybody's favorite. Oh, he's not a pitcher. He's an outfielder. I thought it was a pitcher. So there might be some promise on there for this guy, outfielder. So as you can see, it's the insert rookie card autograph on-card of Mr. Reynolds. It says, congratulations, you received a 1984 Topps baseball autograph from 2019 Baseball Update Series. So when I was opening the pack, I was like, oh! And Luke was like, are you okay, Dad? And I'm like, I pulled an autograph. He was like, are you serious? Because honestly, I have zero expectations when I open stuff. That's like, especially when it's retail. I feel like I never really have a lot of good luck with a retail product. But that was awesome. I got some huge rookie cards, got a cool commemorative patch of Bench, got a bunch of my PC guys, got an autograph, I got a numbered card of that one player, I don't even know what that's about, out of 150. So for a birthday present, I did okay. So thank you very much. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. I think I'm pretty much done with videos now. I think that's it, unless I get something else in the mail. Hopefully we're good for a while. So thank you for watching. Peace, love, and Happy New Year, boys and girls.